Okay, today we are going to integrate sine of ln x over ln x dx when x is varying from 0 to 1, this integral. As we know, sine z is equal to e raised to iota z minus e raised to minus iota z over 2 iota. So, replace z by ln x. We get sine of ln x is equal to e raised to iota ln x minus e raised to minus iota ln x over 2 iota, which is nothing but x raised to iota minus x raised to minus iota over 2 iota. Now comes to the original integral. We have 0 to 1 sine of ln x over ln x dx. This becomes 0 to 1 x raised to iota minus x raised to minus iota over 2 iota ln x. Now consider another integral IA, which is 0 to 1 x raised to iota a minus x raised to minus iota over 2 iota ln x dx. Now compare to original integral which is given. So now our original integral is in fact I1. If we replace a by 1, we get this. Now IA is 0 to 1 x raised to iota a minus x raised to minus iota over 2 iota log x dx. A is any parameter. Now differentiate with respect to a partially means differentiate with respect to a treating x as a constant. And since we treating x as a constant, the integral remains same. We just have to differentiate with respect to a. Now differentiate with respect to a, we get 0 to 1 x raised to iota a iota ln x minus 0 over 2 iota ln x. In fact, x raised to iota after differentiation becomes x raised to iota a iota ln x. Now cancel 2 iota iota ln x from numerator and denominator. We get I dash a is half 0 to 1 x raised to iota a dx. Now integrate it with respect to x. We get x raised to iota a plus 1 over iota a plus 1, limit varying from 0 to 1, which gives you 1 over 2 iota a plus 1. This 1 over 2 iota a plus 1 is in fact I dash a. Now integrate with respect to a. We get iota a is 1 over 2 iota ln iota a plus 1 plus c. Since we are integrating indefinitely, this is indefinite integration, therefore we get a constant c. Now we have to find c. Now how can we find c? Now comes back here. Iota a is 0 to 1 x raised to iota a minus x raised to minus iota over 2 iota ln x dx. If we replace a by minus 1 here, a by minus 1. If we replace a by minus 1 here, we get iota of minus 1 is equal to 0. So iota of minus 1 is 0. Now here, iota of minus 1 is 1 over 2 iota log minus minus iota plus 1 plus c. Since iota of minus 1 is 0, we get c is equal to minus 1 over 2 iota log of 1 minus iota. Now substitute the value of c here. We get iota a is equal to 1 over 2 iota log 1 plus iota a minus log 1 minus iota. But our original integration is this one, which is nothing but iota of 1, means we have to replace a by 1. Now replace a by 1. This is 1 over 2 iota log 1 plus iota minus log 1 minus iota. This is 1 over 2 iota log 1 plus iota over 1 minus iota. And after simplification, it becomes 1 over 2 iota log iota. Iota can be written as e raised to iota pi by 2. And therefore, finally, it becomes pi by 4. So our answer is pi by 4.